Okay, so now in this video, as we've talked a little bit about the dichotomous search method, we've done a few examples and we've looked a little bit at how you can do some mathematical analysis on it. We'll talk a little bit now about how you can actually improve the dichotomous search method slightly before we get into more complicated things. So I'm going to share my screen. Okay. So here's the code for the dichotomous search, or the pseudo code for the dichotomous search that we've talked about before. And so the big thing in terms of looking at the efficiency of an algorithm that we're concerned about is looking at the number of function evaluations that we have. So the big thing that takes up a lot of computation in this search method is that step there, line four, where you have to evaluate the function three different times. So that's the, if f is a really complicated function, that's where all the effort goes. And so now we also know something else about the dichotomous search. We know that for a given a naught and b naught and l, we know how many times this while loop is going to run here. So we know how many times this is going to step through. And so we can calculate what that n is. So we can actually figure out what is m, the number of function evaluations that we have here. And so that number of function evaluations that we're going to get every time we run this search is going to be 3 times n, because we've stepped through this, we iterate through this function, through this loop n times. And each time we iterate through, we evaluate the function 3 times. So the efficiency of that algorithm, in the way that we're going to talk about it in this course, is 3n. So to do to minimize that function using this algorithm, we'll do 3n evaluations, which is okay. It's not that great. So the next question is, can we do better? And the answer is yes. So here is that big. That big cost here in this algorithm. It's doing those function evaluations. And if you think about it, every time we do the function evaluations, we evaluate the function at three interior points, right? So we calculate any three interior points, and then based on where the minimum of the function is at the five now points that we have, we halve the interval. So we end up in one of three different half-size intervals. And so that's next step through the algorithm. If the big cost here is evaluating the function at all of these at these three different points, well, you can reuse information. So let's say that the first time I calculate a, b, c, d, e, those five function values, the smallest value is at c, and so we narrow it down to this interval here, and then I need to calculate the function value at five interior points. I split this up into four equal subintervals that's in the middle here. But the thing there is that I've already evaluated f of d and f of e and f of c. So the next time I step through this algorithm, I really only need to calculate the function value at two new points. Shouldn't actually need to reevaluate. But the way that I'd written my code is I was going to have to evaluate the function at f of c as well as those two interior points. So I'd be wasting effort. So I could save that value of f of c and reuse it the next time. So each new iteration, I only ever actually need to do two new function evaluations rather than three. So that's one efficiency that we can make with this algorithm. And there's also another one that makes things slightly more efficient. And it's the fact that this code uses a while loop. So, the way that this is written here, I'm going to keep checking, whether the width of my subinterval is larger than the smallest tolerance, the smallest size that I want. And then I'm just going to keep running through and checking that every time I run through. But I don't actually have to do that because I know that I can count that I'm going to run through this loop exactly n times. I know exactly how many times it takes to run through this in order to get my subinterval down to being smaller than a width L. So I can save a little bit of computation there as well by pre-calculating what that n is and then converting the while loop into a for loop. And so they're the two changes that we can make here. So I can pre-calculate what n is, and then I can change my while loop to a for loop here. And if I write in that I'm going to save, one of the values of my subinterval each time I halve my interval down and down and down, you can see I can get away with only doing two new computations each time. And that's the big cost saving here. And so now we can actually figure out how many computations we do, what the efficiency of this algorithm is in terms of computations, right? So how many times do I have to do this expensive step here? And so it's going to be, for this modified version of the dichotomous search, the number of function evaluations is going to be, well, the first time I step through the algorithm, I have to always calculate three interior points, with function value at three interior points. So the very first time I step through this loop, I'll definitely have to calculate three things. But every time after that, I only need to calculate two because I always have one point that's saved from the previous iterations. So in the remaining n minus one steps, right? So n minus one times, I only need to do two iterations. So for the final n minus one steps, I need to do two function iterations. And so this becomes 3 plus 2n minus 1. This becomes 2n take away 2 plus 3 is 2n plus 1. So in the most efficient version of this dichotomous search, I need to do 2n plus 1 function evaluations. So it's slightly more efficient than what we thought before. Still not great. There'll still be better methods, and we'll talk about better methods that we can use. But that's how we can figure out the efficiency of this algorithm. So that's pseudocode that I've got here. And you don't have to use pseudocode. We have some actual MATLAB code that's up on MyUni and you can download and check out that implements this algorithm. And it's a good thing to check that out, see if you can understand how it works, and then you can start to use it to solve some examples. So that's it. So I'll stop there. Thank you.